So what? By the way, we're playing Mario Tennis. Hey!
Hi.
The first the first tennis game with Mario in it. Or so I thought when I was, you know, 8 or whatever the hell. Like I viewed this like to me Mario Golf on the N64 was like the first golf game with Mario.
Yeah.
And so I was like, what a weird out of left field thing. And then this tennis thing was like, oh, they're trying to capitalize on that Mario Golf success with this Mario Tennis thing. But I don't think it'll work out. And then I played Mario Tennis and I was like, damn, I'm an idiot. This is super fun.
Yeah, Mario Tennis is really good. You're so loud. I don't know what's going on, though. You're so loud.
Okay, I'm so sorry. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. Hey, what's up? Oh God, my can you turn my earphones down? My earphones are so loud. Oh God, I'm dying. That's good, yes. Manage a little bit up? Just a little up. I need more snare in my earphones. That's perfect. I think I'm good.
Need more high
And
energy,
of
more
course,
action.
Keith, the
What?
first appearance.
Waluigi.
Waluigi.
My man, my main man.
So now that like
World Sexiest Purple Goon.
now that the whole fucking like the way that Waluigi's name is like a pun in Japanese or whatever, I get it. I still think it's really clumsy for like an English-speaking audience, but I get what they were doing. But at the time, it was like, oh, yeah, Wario was clever because you flipped one letter upside down, it became a new letter, and also, you know, changed the meaning of the name. But now you're literally just taking Waluigi and adding Wa to it. Like, that doesn't work at all. And then his logo is an upside-down L, which isn't a thing. I was like, so much about this character was so poorly conceived.
See,
Like, I even as an 8-year-old, I was like, this is a mess, Nintendo. What are you doing?
that's the difference between you and me, is that I saw that and I thought that it was like, because again, neither of us knew that it was the Japanese pun or whatever. But to me, I just thought it was like funny and goofy. Like I wasn't,
Uh-oh.
I never suffered from the illusion that Nintendo wasn't taking Mario villains seriously enough.
No, it's not about taking it seriously. It's just about it being clever. Like, I think Wario was really. I mean, I get now that it's a pun, so it is clever, even though
Right,
it's
yeah.
a pun
For a
for
different
only people
language.
that speak Japanese. But
Yeah.
like, I was just like, there's not. This is the total opposite of clever in every possible way, unlike Wario, which was kind of clever.
Someone is asking about what evil Donkey Kong would be, and we already know
it's
Wonky Kong.
Wonky Kong. I'm sorry to make you get up again, but the game is way too loud compared to our voices in my earphones. If you wouldn't
I
mind.
would fix that if I knew how.
I would settle for just turning my headphones down. Perfect. That's so perfect. Could I can't even tell you.
The issue that we got in an argument about last week, when I fixed it, it took away the ability for us to hear ourselves in the headphones.
Well, that's Keith, I
Yeah?
You can't get mad at me for your audio setup being jacked.
Listen, all I know is that when we do it here, our setup takes 15 minutes instead of an
that's
hour and a
not
half.
true.
It
that
is.
that was true one time.
It was true the last two times. It was only not true this time because you had to go to GameStop. Otherwise, it was true.
Keith?
Yeah.
I'm giving you the choice, but
yeah.
I'm giving you two perfectly serviceable options for controlling a video game,
give
which
me the pro controller,
you
give
hate
me the pro
both of them
controller.
Because you're a maniac.
I hate both of them. Give me the pro controller.
Okay. Yeah, so
give me the one that's at least trying to be a controller.
You're a villain. You are Waluigi. Why am I in the option? I was about to go erase the save data like this was a used cartridge, and I was like, oh, this is a virtual console game on my Wii U. That's never been played, so there's no data. Mario versus Luigi? Is that?
I just want. No, I'm gonna be Waluigi. This isn't.
Oh, really? Oh, sorry. You gotta like hit home, and. Wait, maybe back out and then hit like pull the trigger, and it will give you like a controller. Yeah, controller settings.
Actually, I'm player two.
Yeah, how do you do that?
I had a Red Bull. I'm very burpy.
I'm positive that this is possible.
It would be impossible for it to not be possible.
It's Nintendo. Anything's possible.
Anything's impossible, you mean? They can't do everything, but they can make anything undoable.
Dude, they just, Oh, man, are they really going to do this to me?
What are they going to do to you?
Are they going to, like... Hang on. Are they going to make the fucking Pro Controller have to be player one? Just, it, like, both of them are player one? I don't understand.
Well,
I'm dying. I'm dying.
My last 30 minutes of being overly harsh on Nintendo products has finally paid off.
Dude, you know they just put out fucking Super Mario Maker on the 3DS?
I didn't know that.
And you know what?
What?
It's got the 100 Mario Challenge.
Yeah.
So that you can... It'll pull random levels from their online server, and you play them. It has the level creator, but you can't upload levels, and you can't enter in codes to play specific levels that you want to play.
On the 3DS version. So the Mario Maker part of Mario Maker.
Yeah, it's like fucked. It's like a shambling corpse of a Mario Maker version.
And it's crazy because like adding that stuff in isn't a graphical issue.
It should be totally doable.
It should be totally doable. It's like the fact that my Google Home over there can't make reminders. It doesn't know how to do that yet.
That sucks.
Hey, Google.
That's like...
Remind me to tell you to do a reminder.
Sorry, create reminder is not yet supported.
Right? Like, what is that? It's called a Google Assistant. It can't create a reminder. What else do assistants do? That's like 80% of assistants' jobs.
I think this is everything.
I can Google it. Here's the thing though. I'm remembering now, casting my mind back to a time when my little brother was playing on his Wii U. He's trying to play New Super Mario Bros. U, and you can't play multiplayer with that game with a gamepad and a controller. Everybody has to be using a controller, or you're playing single player on the gamepad.
Yeah.
I kind of don't even want to play this if we can't do versus.
Why? Because Because
I've been putting off us playing this game specifically so that I have a gamepad in the other room. Wait, no, you can't connect your gamepad to the same Wii U. Oh my god, what is... What year do they think it is?
To be fair, the gamepad, the reason you can't use two gamepads on one system,
I get it, because it's not powerful enough to send that much video.
It can only send out 30 frames per second, but like, so if there were two, they'd have to...
Just let me use it with a blank screen, though. Yeah. Let me use the buttons as a controller with a blank screen.
Yep.
It's not crazy. It's just like, they refuse to make...
Oh, no, wait. I got it.
What?
I finally got it.
What?
Okay. We don't have any classic controllers, but we do have Wii remotes. So I can just turn on a Wii remote, set the Wii remote as player one, and then set the Pro Controller as player two. You're closer.
What do I do? I don't know how to use a Wii U because I've had mine for 2 years and I've used it twice.
I was only asking you to pick up a Wii remote and hand it to me.
Oh.
If you can handle that.
Black or white?
Oh, black.
Good answer.
Keith, I have a rhymey saying that has to do with using black controllers for Wii systems.
What is that?
I'll tell you later. It's really, I don't want to say it here because it's so good. I don't want someone to take it from
it's
me.
It probably sounds racist. If you don't want to say it on air, then it's racist. Do you not?
I say plenty of things that aren't racist off air.
Yeah, but none of them you wouldn't say on air. Hey, do you need a nunchuck?
No, but I know you have a black nunchuck, and I want it. I'm so jealous.
You can't have it.
I want it so
it's
bad.
It's got a Triforce on it.
Not the nunchuck.
Yeah, the nunchuck's got a little Triforce on it, I think.
Oh, I think that must be like a custom thing.
That's it not, is, yeah. It's like the it was a special edition Zelda Wii U.
No, but like I'm pretty sure the nunchuck was never a thing.
Okay, maybe.
Like, if you ask Cameron, I bet he'll say that he like bought it from someone who painted a Triforce on it or something.
You know, maybe the nunchuck does not have the Triforce, but the Wiimote definitely does.
Yeah.
Nice.
Sup. 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 All right, here we go.
God.
Problem solved. Guys, we got it. It's fine.
This is so... I hope that...
You know what?
I was going to cut it out. I'm just going to leave in
The
barely audible arguments from beforehand of me talking shit about all this stuff and you going like, no, it's all fine and there's nothing wrong with it.
Whoa, okay.
I was specifically talking about the design and the...
I never said that there was nothing wrong with anything about the Wii U or whatever. I think you just have some very specific opinions about current and future Nintendo products
that
are unreasonable.
Here's the thing that I think Kyle doesn't understand about me, despite just like, you know, years and years of doing this.
Sorry, did you pick Luigi? Because I thought you wanted Waluigi.
I did pick Waluigi.
Okay.
The thing that I don't think Kyle understands about me is that, like, I'm capable of talking shit about all the things that I really, really like. Because I think it's important to talk about the things that aren't good about the things that you like.
That's not fair.
And when I don't like a thing, I am way more specific about what I don't like about it. Because there's a lot more stuff, and there's less good things. Because if like I can spend an hour talking about all the shit that's wrong with KOTOR 2. Like, imagine the shit I could talk about a pro controller. It doesn't mean I'm like actually mad at it.
You sure sound mad at it.
Well, that's just how I sound. You have the same thing.
Could I say this game still controls and plays really well? Like, this is
I just figured out how to run fast. So.
By the way, I don't think you're paying attention to the game.
I was. I didn't know how to move faster than a slow walk. You got a dash.
No, you don't.
Like, I did,
this
yeah.
This is. Are you calling what I'm doing a slow walk? Because that's all I've been doing. I didn't even know you could dash. I don't even know if I knew you could dash back when this game was new. Like, I might have just learned that.
Or no, it was like, you know how in Mortal Kombat you've got to, like, detonate to do the fast walk? Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm just losing my mind.
Yeah, I think so.
You know what? I think you just have advantage server.
No, this game doesn't have dedicated servers.
Oh, not? Really?
Yeah, this is all peer-to-peer.
How do you upload your own levels?
Actually, you can't. Just like the 3DS version of Mario Maker.
Slayer, I'm talking about my Google Home, says it can tell you about a reminder. Yes, it totally can do that. But the problem is that I can't set reminders for it to tell me about. Unless I'm doing... So here's the problem with the Google Home, right? I have two of them, and I bought...
You have two of them?
Yeah. For...
What is wrong with you? There's not
you.
Worth having one.
To explain, Kyle...
Jesus, they're like $180.
They're first of all, I was about to explain why. They're $130.
Okay, please. God, fuck.
They're $130. I got them on Black Friday, so they were $30 off. Or they were $31 off. They were down to $99. Plus I had a Best Buy gift card and a PayPal balance. So I essentially got the two Google Homes for like $30. Not each, just like I had enough.
But that's still money you could have used for anything.
$30? I don't think it's unreasonable to get $260 worth of stuff for essentially $30.
Okay.
Then I bought, because I wanted to set up like Chromecast speakers around my house so that I could do Chromecast stuff.
All right, maybe this is the part I'm missing, right, okay. is that I'm talking like Amazon Echo and Google Home, which are essentially similar competing products.
Yeah.
I literally do not understand like the functional use case for either of those products. And last time I was here, I said, how does Google Home improve your life? And there was just a long pause. And then your boyfriend says, well, having it makes him happy, so that improves his life.
Yeah, there you go.
Like, what is it? Like, why would you want one, let alone two? What does it do for you?
So here's the thing. It's a new product. So there's a ton of stuff that like is incoming that it can't do yet. But like, assuming that it has like the full functionality that it will have.
And what's that?
You know, being able to set reminders and do like finding my phone for
phone
me if I've lost
that.
It and turning it my.
I can hold down the home button on my phone and set a reminder right now. And I was going to say, it's the only thing I use the voice control on it for.
I'm on my phone like all day long. And when I'm at home, I don't like to use my phone ever. Okay. Like I like
that's,
put it in another room. I just don't use it. Because I'm on it all day. And I don't like to be home and also still be on it. And so when I'm doing stuff on the computer or I'm playing a game.
Sorry, stop. How the fuck do you run in this? How do you dash?
I just do like a Mortal Kombat rant.
No, it doesn't work.
Well, then I made it up in my mind. Like, oh, you know what? It's not that. He just has like a gear up time. He just has a see that.
But like, wait, there's just no way that you're not supposed to be able to move faster than I. I just feel like crazy slow.
I just like to be able to ask for songs and have it play the songs. I like to be able to ask it to play a podcast and have it play a podcast. Like, I don't like to have to.
I mean,
here's the other thing is that I like to have a thing where I can have like a average quality speaker playing a podcast at low volume while I play a game through my speakers and not have to have like headphones in at a low volume.
Yeah. So, but. I get, like, my immediate reaction is, like, literally everything you're saying is just stuff I use my phone for when I'm at home.
Yeah.
And I don't understand your aversion to using your phone at home at all, but at the same time, like, I do understand that it's, like, a preference that you couldn't really change. Like, I have things like that with other stuff. I can't really think of them.
Don't get me wrong. It's, like, it's not, like, a necessary product. It is a,
yeah.
If anything, it's like, and the other thing is that like I've been changing around my sleep schedule. I've been like going to bed earlier and waking up earlier, and I've been like, since you've been coming here to do recording, I've been doing all the editing, and so I've been trying to stay on top of the editing, and so I've been trying to use like calendars and reminders and scheduling my time more, and so. Basically anything that will help me like stay on top of like doing stuff that I need to do when I need to do it so that I'm not mismanaging my free time is a help. So like when I can just go like ask the Google Home to tell me about all my reminders and what I've scheduled for myself and it will tell me that plus the weather and then read me a minute and a half of news, like that is a huge time saver.
Gotcha.
Oh, and also like a thing like I don't have to take up my phone and look at the calendars. I can just say like, hey, do this to me, do to me the things I must do. What are you doing?
Okay, I was waiting to see how long it would take you to point out the fact that I wasn't doing anything. I was like, how long will he just talk and let this happen and maybe not even notice that it's happening?
This is fun.
Yeah, this is a fun game. I will say this game looks a lot crisper on the Wii and Wii U than it does on N64 because I didn't know this for a long time, but most N64 Virtual Console games are like double the resolution that they normally were. Like most of them are like 240p on N64 and they're 480 on Wii U and Wii.
Yeah.
So it's double res. It's nice.
So did I do a good job explaining the Wii U stuff? Or not the Wii U, the Google Home stuff?
Google Home stuff. I'll be honest, I tried to listen and kind of blacked out.
You were too busy
point.
Doing your weird, stupid serving ball thing?
Yep.
You suck.
But like, I guess I get it. But like, why do you need two?
The other one is just to control media from. I have a audio Chromecast and a video Chromecast, and so I can just tell it to play videos or play music through my speakers.
I don't know what an audio Chromecast is.
You plug it into speakers and it controls your speakers. So when I play that song through the living room speakers for you, remember that?
Okay.
That's an audio. That's what the audio.
That's interesting.
Does. And the video Chromecast is just a video Chromecast, so I can tell it to.
Regular Chromecast.
Yeah. What's that? Yeah. And so I can. So the I have another set. My old, because these are new speakers on my desk. I don't know if you noticed.
No.
And so my old desktop speakers are in the hallway right now, and so I was gonna set it up because I also. Here's the other thing. I have my headphones. This is another part of the Google Home thing. I have my headphones in, like, 12 hours a day.
Ugh.
Like, or more. Like, all the time. I have just headphones in all the time. And so if I can have a thing where if I'm in my kitchen, in my living room, or in my office, I mean, listening to a podcast on my speakers, which I'm usually doing it on my headphones, but if I play through the Google Home, and then I can just tell it, hey, start playing that in the kitchen so that I can go and make some food, or start playing that like throughout the house so that I can do whatever I need to do, so I can cut down on the time that I've just got headphones in constantly. Why are you doing that? Are you listening to me? Are you ignoring me again? God damn it! I stopped to scratch my nose because you were doing that.
Tri points out an interesting point in the chat. Wasn't Keith putting Google on blast for military contracts? Weren't you?
Yeah, there's no ethical consumption under capitalism, idiot. Like, what am I going to do? Buy from another horrible corporation?
Thank
like,
you.
It's all shitty.
I put this tweet
like,
out.
What am I going to do? Get an Amazon Alexa where they fucking pay their workers jack shit, and in the UK, the delivery drivers have to take dumps in a can in the van so they can do their stuff on time, and they still make less than minimum wage when all their shit is accounted for? Like, no, like it doesn't matter what well, where I buy it, it's all going to be terrible.
Wait.
That's real. That's a real thing. In,
okay,
in the UK,
I,
they're
yeah,
delivery.
I believe you and I don't care.
What?
I don't mean I don't care. I just mean I don't want to talk about it. Let's not get derailed here.
You derailed it. I guess what do you mean by derailed? Do you?
I mean, let's not get away from the thing I was about to say.
Okay.
Which is like, if you don't want to support these monstrous corporations, why don't you just not have like a
yeah, but
speaker
I still
in your
have
house
a,
that you talk to?
I still have a phone. Like it's like it's not like that's not.
Why not just not have a phone? Why not just live in a log cabin in the woods?
That's not helpful to anybody. Like, it doesn't hurt Google that I'm that if I go off the grid.
But if we all went off the grid...
I don't know. I think it's, like, as little as just, like, being a person on Twitter is, I think it's better to just, like, talk about how shitty everything is on Twitter than to, like, disappear forever.
So you're saying that you're here to destroy the system from within?
No.
Oh. Someone in the chat points out a good point. Who the fuck is this blue Mario who's the ref over here? Who is this
guy?
So
do you remember in the first Christopher Nolan the second Christopher Nolan Batman movie at the beginning when there's all the fake ass Batman?
No.
You don't remember that? There's all the fake-ass Batman.
You just mean, like, the League of Shadow Assassins?
No. There's the fake-ass Batman.
Or
and they
is it
go
League
trying
of Assassins?
To...
Or...
No, there's the fake-ass Batman. And they're just regular. They're just dads dressed up like Batman trying to solve crime.
Then
he fucking ties them up.
Whoa. Did you say at the beginning of Dark Knight, or did you say at the beginning of the Christopher Nolan Batman movie?
I said the second Christopher Nolan Batman movie.
Oh, shit, sorry. Okay, I was thinking Batman Begins. I was like, what are you talking about?
No. I specified Christopher Nolan.
I apologize.
That's
the movie's
okay.
Called The Dark Knight. Get with it. Turd.
Anyway, so that's what this Mario is. He's just a fake-ass Mario.
He's just a
dressed up as Mario.
You're saying he climbed up to the top of that tall chair to protest for dad's rights?
No, I'm saying that he came to this place trying to be Mario, and Mario was like, you can't be me. And he said, why can't I be me? And then Mario said, because
I'm
not wearing a blue
hat.
Same joke, different words.
I'm not wearing hockey pants. I'm not wearing hockey
somehow,
pants.
I swear to God, somehow the Batman voice of the guy who plays Bruce Wayne in the Telltale Batman series is like worse than the what's-his-face Batman voice that we just did. Christian Bale. It's worse than the Christian Bale Batman voice.
Are we out of the phase where we have to pretend that anything from Telltale besides the first Walking Dead game was good?
Okay, so I didn't play all of episode one, but they put it out for free of the Batman one.
Yeah.
And I liked everything that I saw of it, except for the fact that it was a technical mess, because of course it is, it's a Telltale game. But except the Batman voice was like, I don't even know if I can play this because all I can hear when Batman speaks is how stupid his voice is.
He's got to disguise his voice or somebody will murder his kid.
But like,
does Batman have a kid in this one?
It's earlier in Batman's career, so no.
Okay. Do you remember fucking... Sorry, excuse me. Do you remember Batman Forever?
Fucking yeah, I remember
Batman. Why isn't all Batman Batman Forever?
Oh, whoa. Sorry. You said Batman Forever, and I think we are both thinking of Batman Beyond.
Yes, sorry.
Batman Forever is that garbage movie with like Jim Carrey. And
that's true. It's not garbage, it's real garbage.
And Tommy Lee Jones.
But it's super funny.
Have you seen anything I've retweeted from the Batman 66 labels Twitter account?
No. What is that? Two, can we get back to talking about how all Batman should be Batman Beyond stuff?
Yes. Batman 66 labels is just it's screenshots from the Batman 60s TV show. And I guess there was just this really bizarre motif on that show where they would just put plain white signs with black lettering labeling like everything in that show. So it's just like a picture of like a weird console with a bunch of computer buttons on it with just a sign that says Bat Computer. But then it starts to be like, like henchmen are wearing shirts that say henchmen on it, and like or like a there'll be like something that has a sign above it that says like lost ancient Mayan treasure. It's like literally everything in the show is labeled to a hilarious degree, and it's really funny, and there's a Twitter account.
That sounds pretty good. Hey, did you notice, and does this I don't know if this happens to Mario, but when I score a goal, my eyes glow.
Yeah, they sparkle with a malice.
A devilish glow.
A dark malice.
A truly demonic glint.
But no, that doesn't happen to Mario because he's not a fucking fiend.
Hey, how come the numbers are wrong?
This is the tiebreaker. This is the second time that we've reached a tiebreaker.
Oh. That's why it doesn't say 15 or whatever.
Yeah.
What do we play to in the tiebreaker?
We're playing a two-set match. Yeah, let's not even get into what the nonsense scoring system of tennis.
Nice.
Nice job. Thank you, fist bump game. I want someone in the comments to explain to us why the scoring of tennis is the way. Why are the first 2 points 15 points and then the third one 10? What is that? What is that? And why is zero love?
And why do they think that the points can't just be 1 point each? Because the game is the same if it's 1 point.
Yeah, why isn't it just 1, 2, 3 points? Seer says Batman Beyond is super good. You're right, Seer is super good.
They
play that fucking like 0G Hi-Li game?
Yeah.
That shit's rad. And I didn't know that was a sport when I first saw that. So the first time I saw Hi-Li, I was like, the Batman Beyond hockey sport is real?
So Waluigi is a technique player. I don't know what that means.
It means you got more technique.
Ooh, I want to be tricky.
Ooh, you're SSX tricky.
It's the only kind I know.
I'm going to be power. We don't have the hidden characters.
I know
one is Donkey Kong Jr.
Oh, wait, is it?
Which technically is just young Donkey Kong. but I don't remember what the other one is.
Well, yeah, but so is Baby Mario, probably. It's unclear.
Ooh, I should be Baby Mario. He's speedy.
When has a baby ever been faster than the grown-up version of themselves?
We're playing Ring Shot.
What's this?
We'll find out. I assume we have to hit it through rings. Do we want to mix it up or do we want to go with hardcore? What are we doing?
Let's go with ball speed, normal, bounce, strong.
That's hard. So your answer to do you want to do the same one is yes.
Oh, let's do a different one then. Let me see them all. Slow, no. No. Yes.
That's a really good sound effect, by the way.
Thank you.
Oh, Keith, did you make Mario Tennis? Were you just about to say, how do I move?
Yeah, it was just in the D-pad. It didn't work.
So, Keith, on a scale of 1 to 10, how utterly...
tricky?
How utterly handicapped are you by the fact that the buttons are below the right analog stick?
Not any for this game.
Thank you.
But for this game?
Well, then what are the games that it's a big hindrance for you?
A game that would use the right analog stick.
Like, really? Really?
Yeah, I hate it.
What games are you... What games? What games have you played on the Wii U that you've been like, oh,
I haven't played any games on the Wii U because I hate it.
You're a fucking monster.
And I want to be clear. I don't hate the games. I hate the Wii U and playing on it and doing anything with it.
Well, you're in luck because they're going to be re-releasing every fucking game for the Wii U on the Switch.
Great.
Keith Carberry, the one person in the world mad about the Nintendo Switch.
No, I like the Nintendo Switch.
That's not what I've been hearing. Ah, fuck.
We talked about it before. I just think it's insane that they're still doing a weird thing. Like, I think they need a generation to reset.
No, but see, like, being portable and home console hybrid, you're right, is like an unusual, weird new thing. But it's the most standard, like, hook that their system has had since the GameCube.
You're right, but they don't need a hook. They need to get good at the literal basics of making a modern console. A thing that they not only have not done, but are seemingly hostile towards doing. Like, their systems are functioning at the level of, like, 2007. And in most cases, still even worse than that. Like, I had better online experiences playing, like, Halo fucking 2.
Yeah, but, like, I get all those online experiences on my Xbox and PS4. So, like, I don't need amazing online experiences.
You're right.
I just need Nintendo.
They don't need to be the console that does it best. But that's, like, and it might not be what you and I care about from Nintendo consoles, but that's the only, that's what the people who, the companies that funnel the hundreds of millions of dollars that it takes to make video games, that's what they care about. And if that stuff isn't there, then the games won't be there. And then we'll just have another console that's
just like... I
don't agree,
because
there's 300 shitty games for kids made by developers that only do that, and then a handful of really awesome Nintendo games.
I don't agree, because I think there's a pretty good third-party turnout on the 3DS. And that doesn't have any really,
that's,
like,
that's
online
true,
stuff.
That's true, but those are, like, dedicated... Those are, like, the holdover developers from, like, when... Those are, like, from... Those are just portable games. And portable
yeah, but,
games
like,
really...
the Nintendo Switch is portable.
Kind of, but we... Well,
no,
we
not
won't...
kind of.
No, you're right. It's portable, but we won't... We won't... Those are the kind of games that we'll see, then. We'll see the games that... We'll see games that are, like... Okay, now you can play 3DS games on your TV, not, hey, now you can play Wii U games on your 3DS. That because that's the resources that those companies have. And I don't know for sure about any of this.
That doesn't sound true to me.
That's just my impression of it.
Okay. But...
I'm not mad at Nintendo.
Basically,
I'm
what you're saying is
it,
that
yeah.
the problem with the idea of no third parties making home console style games on the Switch is that there won't be any. But like, what third party home console games are you going to play on a Nintendo console? You're going to play them on your PC or your Xbox or your PS4.
I was thinking of console exclusives. Like, if they had a strong base of just a handful of console exclusives. Because there's going to be a handful of really great Nintendo games.
No.
If they could have even another handful of, like, okay, Ubisoft, over the course of 5 years, makes two really great games that are exclusive to the Nintendo Switch, and then a couple other developers publishers do the same thing. Like, that would essentially, like, add, like, 75% of viable, good, interesting games.
Here's the thing, though, is that you're saying that you want...
Ooh, I'm Luigi.
You're saying that you want a, holy shit, what? I barely remember this madness. Holy crap.
Oh, that's not how to do.
Nope. You're saying that you want a standard console from Nintendo, but that
you want
the idea of, like, third-party Nintendo console exclusives, but the thing is, the whole reason that Nintendo got weird about it with their consoles was that nobody was buying standard third-party games on Nintendo consoles. Like, if Nintendo's system is just going to be just like the Xbox, why would anyone put out their game on just the Nintendo console and not the Xbox?
I think that you're treating Nintendo's position as an untouchable cursed platform for third parties.
It is.
As like, well, no, I think that you're, it is. But I think that you're treating that as like a thing that they can't help. But that's their decisions on how they make their consoles directly affect people's willingness to make games on it. It's not just the nature of Nintendo is that. No, the nature of their the choices that they make are that.
Well,
if they make different choices, then that wouldn't be the case.
And I don't agree because the GameCube was what you're describing, and the fucking market bore out that nobody wanted to play third-party games on the GameCube.
Was it, though?
Yeah.
I mean, it kind of was, but it had a weird controller. Super weird controller. It had tiny little discs that couldn't fit stuff, and it was technically equal strength, but the way that it was built...
It was totally great. It was actually graphically the strongest of the three platforms.
It had the strongest GPU. It had the strongest GPU, but didn't have some sort of weird constriction where it couldn't make use of all of the power that it had because of the RAM or something.
It had concessions in some areas, but there was nothing about it that made it in any way, like, markedly inferior to the other platforms.
Someone, I can't read their name, says, I would say that is their nature. It's a corporation. It doesn't have a nature. It's just a giant blob of decisions.
Well...
like, that's all that it is.
That's not true, though, because Nintendo's, like... the higher-ups at Nintendo, there's, like, definitely, like, a Nintendo culture. It's like, this is the way Nintendo does things, and this is the way Nintendo feels. And usually all those things are terrible.
Right.
Like...
but that's what I'm saying. Like, they need to fire those people or teach them how to do a good job. Like, that... like, it's insane that... it's insane that in order to trade Pokemon with my friend at work, we've got to, like, type in garbage numbers into a box.
Yeah.
Like, it's crazy. This game came out this year.
That is crazy.
And I get that that's the architecture, but, like, the architecture of the original Xbox didn't support what Halo 2 had on its... and I know that that's the example that I'm using a couple times, but that's, like, a pretty good example of a good online experience built for a thing that didn't have online experience was built into it. And I want to rephrase the thing that I said earlier. I'm not looking for them to make a standard, like, by-the-numbers console as much as I want them to... instead of focusing on, like, what's our hook, I want their hook to be, however they need to get it done, making a console that does the things that people and developers and publishers expect the console to be able to do. Like, have functioning online, have controllers that work without you needing to hook them up to each other, and, like, a ton of other crazy things like that.
Okay, but, see, I agree that, like, the Switch does, like, it has a gimmick, and its gimmick is that it's, like, a portable home hybrid. But I think it is, unlike the Wii U, and the Wii, I guess. Why are we seeing that so many times?
It was
what the fuck
so
was
good.
That?
It was so good.
Unlike the Wii and Wii U, like the gimmick of the Switch serves to make it like easier. It serves to make it more to better accommodate people and what they want out of the system. Like, it's not like, ah, this system's fucking weird. Just try to design a game for this. We dare you. It's like, no, this is perfect. Like, some people really like Nintendo portable games, but they wish they could play it on a TV. Some people like Nintendo's home console games, but they wish they could play it on their handheld. Well, now it's all one thing. Just play them however you want. They're all the same games. Who gives a shit? It's like it's making it simpler for people, even
I
if
think,
it...
I think that you're totally right that this is a gimmick that, like, actually serves to make the console more interesting and easier to come up with an idea for, because you're not constricted to either you have to have it in your pocket or you have to have it plugged into your TV. But I don't think that says anything about how they're going to handle the other really glaring weaknesses that Nintendo has had for a decade.
I get it. You're right. Like, I'm not here to say, like, oh, Nintendo doesn't have to have good online. Like, just they have bad online. Just deal with it. It's fine. But, like, I'm not saying I don't want them to try to do better at online, but I'm saying that, like, in a world where I have three game systems that are great at online,
yeah.
The fact that Nintendo isn't good at online, like, doesn't fucking wreck my world. Like,
yeah.
I can deal with
and
it.
And here's the other thing, is that the games that I like from Nintendo are games like this where most games I just want to play by myself. A lot of Nintendo games are really good party games. They're really good games to play with friends, and also the most accessible games out of any of the three, like any of the three, like
first party
things, right? Like, so, like, this is like Nintendo games are a game that I could convince, like, my sister or a cousin that isn't super into video games, or like a friend at work, to get a Nintendo Switch
what?
And play games like this with me because of how accessible they are broadly and also are good. And so it doesn't have to have good online because the other systems do that, but if any system was a system that I want to play with friends, it's going to be a system like this where it's got, like, Mario Party and tennis and, like, Pikmin co-op shit.
Wait. When you say a system like this, do you mean the Wii U, the one we're playing, or the Switch?
Sorry, I meant games
about?
Like this, not a system like this.
Okay. But I don't think there's any, like, guarantee that you won't. I mean, we don't know how many controllers you can sync up to that thing.
Yeah.
I mean, you can at least do two-player on it because of those Joy-Con things.
I'm going to assume four controllers.
I would assume so. And, like, if it hooks up to a TV, then, like, that's your Mario Party right there. Like, I don't see how that hinders you.
For, like, playing games online.
Oh, like, online with other people?
Yeah. Because I live in Pawtucket now. Everybody that I know is, like, an hour away. So I can't just be like, hey, everybody come over. Let's play Mario Party. It's like, okay, just try to get, because my days off are Monday and Tuesday. Let's try to get three people to drive an hour on a Monday night.
Yeah.
To play Mario Party. Like, it's not going to happen. Like, I need to play. Like, it's either it's online or it's nothing.
I don't know what Try is agreeing with in the chat here. They just said, yeah, it also helps that Nintendo is very good at making games. And for me, that's just what it comes down to is, like, Nintendo is one of the best game developers, and it just so happens that they put their games out on exclusive hardware. So the fact that, like, I'm not trapped into either playing something on the go or playing something on my TV and I can just pick is honestly, it's what I've always wanted from every console. This is just the first one to give it to me, so I'm very happy.
I want to restate. I've said it before today and the last time that you talked about the Nintendo Switch, where we were just excited about it and not being critical about it, but I am excited for the Nintendo Switch.
I'm not being critical about it.
What's that?
I'm not being critical.
No, I'm being critical.
I'm hecka stoked.
Yeah, I'm excited for it. I'm just worried that it's going to have a lot of the same issues, because every time I've been like, well, here's the time where they figure their shit out, they never have. And if anything, it hasn't gotten worse, it's gotten better.
All right,
relatively to everything else, gotten worse.
Okay, so I'm not saying that it's not likely that the online will... Fuck.
You're not saying that it is
I forgot which character I was.
Yeah, I did the same thing.
I'm not saying that it's unlikely that the online system for the Switch will be jacked. Like, I think it's totally possible, because every time we have said, surely Nintendo understands online at this point, finally, now, but then they still don't. And so, like, I agree that it'll probably be bad, but I just don't see what it is about the Switch that you think makes it less inclined to have good online. Like, no matter what their system was, the online would still be fucked up and stupid. Like, that doesn't have anything to do with being a console handheld hybrid.
I'm not saying that it's because of what the Switch is. I'm just saying, like, if they had come at... Because their messaging was like, look at the Switch. Look at the things they can do. It's in your house. It's on your pocket. Right? And, like, great. That's a good way to market that.
You can bring it to a rooftop party, and three other people can watch you play Mario 64.
On the roof. Do you want to watch Mario on a roof?
Be on a roof when Mario's on a roof. This is the thing I didn't really notice at the time, but that, like, everyone in that trailer is doing the thing in real life that they're also doing in the game. Like, the people playing Mario Kart are in a car, and people playing, like, NBA 2K on a basketball court, and then, the people on a rooftop are playing with Mario on a rooftop.
Here's, like, the impossible scenario that, like, here's the spirit of what I want to happen. Do you remember when Domino said... We get it. We fixed it.
Yeah.
We get it. Like, I want that. That's what I want. I want them to go, like, we understand the things that you've been saying. Here is what we are doing.
Yeah.
It's a video game console that plays video games with your friends, and it's not always impossible about everything. So. Like, we found someone that used to work at Xbox. We hired them, and they told us how to do it, and it took 4 minutes.
Sorry, back to your thing about, like, the Domino scene. Do you remember when McDonald's stopped making its own coffee and started serving Green Mountain coffee?
Yeah.
And there was that commercial where there's, like, a guy in the bushes across the street from McDonald's, and he's got, like, binoculars, and he's, like, anxiously using the binoculars to watch the front door of the McDonald's. And he's, like, he's really tense. And then, his friend walks out the front door of the McDonald's holding a cup of coffee, and he just holds it up in the air and goes, "It's good!" And he's like, "Oh, yes!" Do you remember that?
I do kind of remember that, yeah. It was a few years ago. It was, like, 6 years ago, but yeah, I remember.
I don't know. There's something about that commercial that always tickled me. I just really like the idea of McDonald's making a commercial where people are like, "Holy shit, the coffee's not terrible anymore."
Did they have bad coffee? Were they known for that?
They were known for having terrible coffee. It was before I drank coffee, so I never tried it, but it was like a thing everyone always said about McDonald's.
I assume that it's not good still, though.
No, it's fine. It's Green Mountain. It's good.
What does that mean, though?
It's one of the most popular coffee brands. It's Green Mountain.
I guess, but Domino's is one of the most popular pizza places, and that's not good pizza.
Yeah, but like, Green Mountain was one of those popular coffees before it was the McDonald's coffee. When McDonald's started serving Green Mountain, it was like, oh yeah, like, that makes sense, because Green Mountain is a good coffee people like.
Okay. I've never had it. Never had Green Mountain coffee.
It's fucking better than Dunkin' Donuts. Dunkin' Donuts sucks.
Dunkin' Donuts does suck. Starbucks kind of sucks.
Honestly, there have been many times that I have gone through a McDonald's drive-thru just for a coffee.
Yeah?
Yeah. Why are you looking at me like that?
I misheard you, is why. I heard you say it's better than Dunkin' Donuts, and then I heard you say... there are many times I've gone through a Dunkin' Donuts drive-thru just for coffee, and I was like, well, you just said that you didn't like Dunkin' Donuts coffee.
I might have said that. I don't know.
I couldn't tell
you.
Who knows?
But you have correctly surmised that I meant, or maybe
McDonald's.
Did say McDonald's drive-thru.
Right, yeah.
Try says, the Wii U could have had the best dev tools, but its limitation in power and poor sales were never going to get it support in the long run. I don't think it had anything to do with power. I think it was just the fact that no one bought it. I mean, that is...
Well, that's the other thing, is that there's like, so many things that go into what makes a console live or die, and And a thing that makes people want to develop a console isn't for a console isn't power, but a thing that makes a good marketing tool, like, it's the culture of people buying the systems is based on power. And so that's a factor in why it didn't sell well, probably.
Can I, I'm sorry, I want to interrupt. Slayer is just confirming I did say McDonald's. Okay. So.
Yeah, I just misheard. And we totally shouldn't have a video game culture that is so bent on, like, it's so fucking it's like a holdover from the 90s ads where it's like you play a video game and you see like electricity coming
now
in.
Now you're playing
from the
with
wall
power
into from the wall into the system through the wire of the controller and then like into your brain. Your eyes glow and your hair's like the fucking the Nintendo block that is fucking pumping with power. The Sega Genesis X249 got so much power it's gonna blow the shit out of your butt. Like it's
Minoru Arakawa will make you his bitch.
And like that, like we got rid of like edgy post X original Xbox, but we never got rid of like coarse power coursing through your vent. Like it's all that stuff is all still there.
At the end of the day, it does. I get why people want powerful consoles because they can do more
right
than not powerful consoles.
Well, graphically.
I was disappointed when the Wii U turned out to essentially be graphically comparable to like a PS3 and 360. I was like, oh man, why? But at the end of the day, like since I've had my Wii U, I've had a ton of fun with it playing lots of different games, and I really never stopped and went like, but I wish it was as powerful as my PS4.
No, you're right. I'm not saying that it's a lot. Like, it's like there are things that power is good for. It doesn't really have anything to do. Like, not having as much power in certain ways can limit what you can do with a game console. But it is not really a make or break thing. Oh, I'm not in this.
I don't know what's happening.
I don't know either. Like, you can make perfectly. Like, hey, guess what? There's been good games for decades, and you didn't always have.
Yeah. Also, I mean, and maybe this is even more of a thing now than when the Wii U came out, but often I find the games that I'm playing on Xbox One and PS4 are like these smaller indie games or like re-releases of old games that don't even take advantage of the power of those consoles.
Yeah. I mean, I wouldn't say that's true across the board, right? Like, the last game that I played on my Xbox One was a smaller indie game. I can't remember what it was, but I remember what it was. But right now I'm playing Final Fantasy 15, the first Final Fantasy game I've ever played.
Really?
Yeah.
That's not true. You've dabbled in some.
Fantasy.
You played
2.
Enough of Final Fantasy 7 to let me know that you hated it, and it broke my heart.
Is that true?
Yeah, you said you didn't like it.
Remember that at all. I must have done it. I played like an hour or 2 hours of Final Fantasy X.
This blows my mind. I mean, maybe it's just something that I can't relate to because I've played so many Final Fantasies over the years for so long. But I always see people that like talk about like getting into Final Fantasy. Like, how do I get into Final Fantasy? Or like, there's a new Final Fantasy coming out. Is this gonna be good for people new to the series? It's like, there's nothing. They're not connected in any. Just play any of them whenever. They're all their own thing.
Yeah. That's what. Yeah, I was.
It, I don't know.
I mentioned that to Cam when I was playing this game, and he has not played any Final Fantasy, and he did not know that. Because I guess he has a friend that was excited that there was a character in 15 that was in one of the other games, and it was like, they're not connected, but they have like the same characters. And I was like, no, they essentially are all not connected in any way except for occasionally having a thing.
Yeah, I think at one point Nicole was like, I kind of want to get into Final Fantasy, but like, I don't know. Should I start with the first Final Fantasy? I was like, no, don't do that.
Hey, skip the first. Like, I mean, and again, I have not played. I know enough about Final Fantasy to be able to say this without having played them. Some people, like Kyle, would say like, "Hey, play Final Fantasy VII if you want to."
Well,
a lot of people would say, "No, VIII is the good one to play." And then, I would say like, if you want to start with an earlier Final Fantasy to get into Final Fantasy, I would say start with 10. And I think that that is the right thing to say.
Did you just say that 10 is an earlier Final Fantasy? You just made so many heads explode.
Yeah, sorry. Guess what? That was on the PS2. Fuck you guys. Hey, it's 2016. The PS, any game that came out on the PS2 is an old game.
But remember, though, 11 and 14 were MMOs, which don't count. So there's actually only been two Final Fantasies since 10. Oh, three. I guess there's been three.
Yeah.
But you also, like, you don't, you have, know, to...
Like, that's... They're, like...
Oh, I just want to say real quick, whether or not Final Fantasy VII is actually recommendable to anybody now in 2016 is, like, a whole can of worms that I don't even want to get into.
I believe it when people say, fuck Final Fantasy VII, play Final Fantasy VIII. Like, I believe those people...
No, I think you're thinking that people say VI.
No one says play Final Fantasy. You know, it might... You're right, it might be VI. I believe those people. But only because I apparently played 7 and didn't like it. I don't remember that, though. Am I part of this tournament? What's going on? What are you doing?
You're not.
Did you cut me out?
I mean, I don't know. We could see it. Maybe there's a tournament mode. No, there isn't.
What are we doing?
We're just talking.
Do you know that there is, like, a very small amount of people that were really... And I don't know if they were annoyed, but I think they were disappointed that you spent two recording sessions being high on drugs.
High on drugs?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Ah, fuck those people.
Someone
was
like,
going through a hard time, Keith.
Someone was like, is this going to be every recording
session? Yeah, it's going to be forever. SSJ 420
it's like
Goku.
It's like the reverse of David Everton, where the dad is like, is this going to be forever?
Is my child never going to snap out of this?
Did the dentist break my kid? Do you remember 3 years ago when I made that really good David after dentist joke?
No.
It was good.
I'm telling you that I believe you. I said I believe you.
I said the only thing scarier than David after dentist is David immediately before dentist. Because he's got to go to the fucking dentist to get his head drilled.
All right. Totally lost the thread on everything. Final Fantasy, weird thing.
Yeah, I like 15 so far. I've only played like 2 or 3 hours of it.
It seems,
and I assume
cool.
that it's what, like 200 hours?
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
Someone said that one of the boss fights took like 60 hours. I don't know I don't know what that means, but no. It's got to be a lie.
Yeah.
The animals get pretty big, so that you fight when you go around fighting animals in that game. Here's something about 15 that I really like. I really like the idea that there's, like, all this modern technology, but it's presented in, like, a very regal, medieval way.
Yeah. Yeah.
Where they've got a car called the Regalia, and it's, like, this royal,
nice.
This royal convertible. It's very funny, and they treat it like it's a fucking coach wagon. It's
That's
very
great.
Funny.
Yeah. I want to play that game, but I just bought like 6 games, so I like can't really. And plus, it's such a commitment to get into one of those games.
Yeah, I mean, I guess if you spend $60 on a game and you play it for 15 hours and you like those 15 hours and you stop, even if you're only 5% of the way in, then who cares, right?
I know, that's
like
you're not wrong.
Like, 8 years ago, if I heard myself saying that, I'd be like, you idiot. What are you talking about? And now I'm like, whatever. My time's my time. Fuck off. Fuck off, Team Keith. We're talking about Final Fantasy 15.
And Final Fantasy in general.
Sure.
I don't know how... I don't think... We've been playing this for a long time. We should probably wrap up. I just want to say... Really, everyone likes to give, like, their definitive word on Final Fantasy, like, it's all 6, motherfucker, like, and that's most of it, but I think really the definitive word on Final Fantasy is, you have to understand that Final Fantasy is a franchise that's literally been going for 30 years, and everyone, depending on their age and when they got into Final Fantasy, has their Final Fantasy era that they think is the best, and nothing will ever compare to it.
It's all Final Fantasy 2, motherfucker.
Yeah, so like when you go up to somebody and say, what Final Fantasy should I play? And they're like, oh shit, dog, it's all about 4. And then you play Final Fantasy 4 and you're like, this game is standard as fuck. What the hell is this about? I'm bored. Like, it's because like they're working off this like crazy intense nostalgia that will never translate over to you.
Yo, it's all about Final Fantasy Crystal
Chronicles. You need that? You hold the bucket.
I played that. That's the game I played.
We should play that.
I played that with
that
Dylan.
That was a cool game.
I played that with our cousin Dylan.
Yeah, how's he doing?
I don't know. Is he gay? Yeah.
Is he gay yet?
Yeah, he is.
Is he?
Yeah.
When did that happen? Did I know about that?
I don't know. I also don't know Dylan.
I guess so.
Yeah.
You seem like you might. You probably know him better than I do.
Probably. So we played Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles together when that was a relevant thing to be playing. And then since then, I've seen him 3 times.
Okay, sure.
Which is like, what, 3 times more than you? But like, it's still. Dylan's nice.
Okay.
I like Dylan. What were we talking about? And then I played Final Fantasy 2 on my iPhone. When I was the sort of person that would play a game on my iPhone
and what,
waste my time that way.
How is that? Because
whatever, standard
Final
shit.
Fantasy 2 is a thing. Final Fantasy 2 is not standard. It's fucking
standard.
Weird.
No, it was not weird. It's very standard.
It's very weird.
Super, super standard. Like Super Nintendo era RPG, like very. Exactly
well, yeah,
that.
But do you know how the level up system works in that game?
I can't remember.
It's almost like an Elder Scrolls game where you increase your stats by using those things. So you increase your like health and defense by taking damage. So like the way people grind in that game is like they'll attack their own characters to like grind up their defense stat stuff.
Oh,
that
I don't think
that shit is weird as hell.
Maybe I didn't play 2. Maybe I played. I mean, it's possible. This was what I was doing with my fucking iPhone 3G or whatever. Like that's what was going on at the time.
I'm gonna throw this out there. If anyone's like, you know what, I just want to play like an 8-bit ass standard as fuck RPG. Like just get that classic vintage JRPG business going on. Go play like one of the early Dragon Quest games. Go play Dragon Quest
Trigger.
1.
That's a good one.
That's, yeah, but that's like
you're too good.
That's a that is like it. That's a late era 16-bit RPG. It's like a different thing. And also, no, I've never found Chrono Trigger to be like very compelling.
It's a well, none of like, those I games can, are very compelling anymore.
Yeah,
but like
I know.
In relation to all of the other games, it's better. I think it's better. I think it's better in a noticeable way.
Yeah, I could see where
but it's not
going
to blow your mind in 2016. It's just going to be
yeah.
It's just going to be the best of the standard ass old ass RPGs.
I guess that's it's kind of what I want to get across. So often I just hear these people like emphatically recommend 8 and 16-bit RPGs to people that like don't know what they're getting into like.
Yeah.
And yeah, like just don't listen. You can enjoy 8 and 16-bit RPGs. I'm not saying you can't or anything because I do it all the time, but like just know what you're getting into.
Yeah, it's like so it's really it's like a couple steps above like people in a theater watching a train drive at the screen. Like
it's like being in a theater with a train driving at the screen?
Yeah, it's like that fucking famous clip of like one of the first like movie screenings that people went to see.
Yeah.
Where it was like the train would
like,
drive
oh,
at the
no,
screen.
The train's
and
everyone
like, oh, it's so exciting. And it was, like, it was so exciting just to be playing of like a video game at that level.
Yeah.
That it's just like the writing isn't interesting, the mechanics are super basic, like it's like the super early shit that medium was capable
of. Yeah, like
of doing.
In Final Fantasy IV, there are all these like story moments where characters will like sacrifice themselves to save the other members of the party. And like now you can just be like, this story's boring. Like it's like whatever, this character's dead, I don't care. But at the time that stuff didn't happen in like games didn't have stories practically.
Right.
So,
because
like,
the people that were writing the stories were the people that were just like that knew how to code.
Yeah.
Like there wasn't like a story team, right? And if there was, it was like, hey, you're the programmers that are the story team.
Yeah. Sure.
And so they, like, they were less interested in and less capable of, and just not, the medium had not evolved to the point where you could have, like, a game that felt compelling, meshing properly with a story that also felt compelling.
I want to address Tooth in the chat real quick. He's saying that he's been trying to get into Monster Hunter on 3DS, and he can't comprehend why these developers insist on using this platform. It's because Monster Hunter has a thing where they've always been really dogged in putting out Monster Hunter on the system that sold the best. And in Japan specifically, there's like a whole like handheld like local multiplayer culture around Monster Hunter, so they just put it out on the handheld that sells the best in Japan, and that was the PSP last generation, and this generation it's the 3DS, and that's why Monster Hunter's on the 3DS. Mystery solved.
What an insane tradition for them.
Is it, though? I mean, like, put your system out on the one that most people have? I don't know.
I guess, but I don't know. I just feel like it would be easier for them. Like, they would probably make more money by saving money switching architecture all the time.
Well, no. I mean, they're switching architecture, like, every, like, six
years.
Yeah,
no, you're right. You're right. Yeah. But they're also only making one or two games in that span.
I mean, there's been... There was three on the 3DS, and there was three or four on the PSP.
There's one on the Wii U, right?
Yeah. That was 3 Ultimate.
Are they going to put
out
another
one
on
the 3DS. That came out like it was like a day and date multiple.
Right, and then they didn't do that with 4.
Right, 4 was handheld only.
Probably because the Wii U sold like shit.
Yeah.
That's cutthroat.
Yeah. It was kind of, I don't remember if they put it out. Yeah, they never put it out in America, but in Japan, they also did the same thing with PSP, where like they ported the PSP game to PS3 just so you could play the PSP game on your TV if you wanted.
Right. Hey, what if the Vita worked? What if that, like...
Oh, man, the Vita is such a good system. The thing about the Vita is that everyone... It's impossible to, like, recommend to somebody because when you look at the list of exclusives, it doesn't exist. Like, there aren't any exclusives.
Hey, should I get a Vita? How much do you like anime games?
How much do you like Atelier? No, the real question is, like, how much do you like playing indie games that you already have on other platforms? Which is a really weird thing to say, but it's, like, all these games that I have, like, Spelunky and, you know, things of that, like, ilk.
Right.
Of, like... Like, low power indie game that doesn't need to be on a home console. Like, it was really nice to be able to play Spelunky in bed or anywhere else. And, like, I just have, like, a ton of those kinds of games on Vita. And that's not something you can recommend a system on, but it's nice to have.
Can you rephrase that as Spelunky in the sheets?
Yeah.
And then what would you be in the streets?
What's the... Got grape slungy in the streets, splunky in the sheets.
Nailed it.
Sure.
You still playing this?
Yeah. To be fair, Monster Hunter on my new 3DS with the extra joystick thing sort of isn't terrible. Yeah, no, it's totally not terrible. It's fine.
Yeah, it's fine.
And you know what? I'm one of the crazy people that bought a Circle Pad Pro just to play Monster Hunter 4 on it, and I fucking loved that thing. It was great. I was like, I want to play all my 3DS games on the Pro Stick thing, because it was more comfortable. They added grippiness to it. It was all molded and nice.
Yeah, I mean, I don't like Monster Hunter at all, but there's no complaints on, like, it not working properly. Like, it works as intended. It's just that I don't like.
I think there were a lot of complaints from people that, because it... Oh, it actually launched, I think, like, day and date with the new 3DS, or, like, very close in that window or whatever.
Yeah.
And the complaint was, like, yo, this game needs a second analog stick, but I either need to buy a new 3DS or buy a weird add-on thing that you don't even make anymore.
Right.
And otherwise, it's some...
When I worked at
GameStop...
It's
a lesser experience.
When I worked
at
GameStop, people would come in all the time looking for circle pads.
Really?
And, yeah. And... Every time I had to tell them, like, no, I'm sorry, they only have the circle pads in Japan. you have to get a CirclePad Pro. And they were like, well, I don't have that size 3DS. And then I was like, well, then you don't have a CirclePad. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Was that what it was? Was the CirclePad Pro in America was the smaller one, and they only made the XL version in Japan?
Okay. No. They only made the you know what? That might be what it was. They only made the XL one in Japan.
Yeah.
Because
I had to import mine from like.
Yeah.
But I mean, they're on Amazon for like $20 or whatever. I mean.
Right.
It's not a hard thing. I didn't have to,
I didn't
have to fucking call up my Japanese contact.
No, but once, for so many people, once you say, sorry, you have to get this online, it's just like, you might as well have told them that you have to dig it up. Like, you have to follow a treasure map and dig it up. Like, it's just not, they're just not going to do it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Like, the GameStop crowd is totally not going to go out of their way to get a Japanese-only peripheral.
Like, can you imagine being the sort of person that says, like, besides the fact that you did do that this tonight, but the sort of person that, like, needs something, and their first thought is like, oh, I gotta go to GameStop.
Yeah. Like, so, it's not just tonight. I do that, much less in the recent months, but I used to do that a lot, but it wasn't because, you know, GameStop was my go-to source, power to the players. It was just because I'm too fucking impatient when I want things, and so I go to a store to get them immediately instead of waiting 2 days for them to show up my house.
I agree, but that's the bargain, right? The bargain is like, do I want this thing like cheaper and more convenient, or do I want it now?
Now is more convenient. Well,
no,
okay.
It's not more convenient
because you have to go
it's just
there.
Faster,
yeah.
And also a lot of the times it will cost more money, but I'm talking about the people who like. They're like, instead of saying, I need something, should I order it online or go to the store? They go, I need something. Which store do I go to?
Yeah.
That's who I'm talking
like,
about.
Like, you know, it's like, it's not like they showed up to GameStop because they didn't want to wait for the shipping time. Like, you were like, oh, sorry, GameStop doesn't have these CirclePad things, but they are online. And someone went, no, I guess I'm just not getting it then.
Yeah. So, I guess. You know what I hate about this game? If you
it's all the same?
No, if you serve the ball and it whacks the other person in the face and falls on the ground, they lose.
Well, but the thing is, that's because they didn't swing in time. Like, they were late on their swing.
But in real tennis,
uh-huh.
If you get hit by the ball before it's bounced...
Oh, yes, Keith, you're right. This is not real tennis. This is a Mario game.
Right, but all the other rules are tennis rules.
But that's because, wait, in real tennis, if you get hit by the ball, it's your loss?
Is it?
Yeah, because you're supposed to hit the ball. It's not,
if
it's
you're
like,
right
oh
up there
shit, dude.
And they fucking line drive it into your head, that's not on you, that's on them.
No, it's, that can't be.
Someone look it up.
Someone look it up.
Look it up.
We're not going to do it.
Don't need no email.
Tennis is all about fucking rocketing a rubber ball at the other person's court as fast as possible. Like, oh yeah, hit it really fast and really hard over towards that person, but don't hit them or then it's your fault. Because then people are just going to be jumping in front of balls. I could have backhanded this back at my opponent, but instead I let it smack me in the face. My point. Tri says it's totally on you. At least it was in high school. And high school is real life, so counts.
High school is not real life, but I will submit.
Wait, no. High school is real life.
That,
what?
No, high school is not real life.
What?
But high school tennis is real life tennis. So.
Man, we really fucking made this game last.
This is a good game.
Hey, whatever.
Yeah, sure.
We're not really paying a ton of attention to it, but it's fine. It's just a fun game to play. Yeah, fuck you. Smack you in the face with that ball. All right, are we done here? Keith is like furiously looking
at tennis. I'm just reading. Kyle always is trying to imply that I'm mad about stuff.
Oh, no. I didn't mean furious like you're mad. I mean furious like you're like frantically. I guess is a better way to say it.